Say you have a project ahead of you. Hardware is selected and ordered, electrical design process is ongoing, you're doing PLC and HMI part, and already have some ideas you want to test. But hardware is still not there. Thankfully, Automation Builder and Panel Builder software offer solid simulation capabilities. But what if I told you there is a way to connect PLC and HMI simulators together and get even better commissioning experience? Intrigued? My name is Yuri. You're watching That Little Thing in PLC. Let's get started. So, what do we have here? Real simple application just for demonstration purposes. Circular counter is being incremented each cycle, and then check against threshold value. If it's greater or equal, then it is reset to zero, alright? Variables are declared as global in GVL list, and then we have symbol configuration section where we select exactly those variables to be available in HMI. To finish with symbol configuration, we need to build an application and generate code. Next step, we go to CP600 panel item, tick the checkbox Update Panel Builder Project on Launch. By doing that, we'll create tags in HMI project automatically. This checkbox is not available in basic version of Automation Builder, so you would need to do tag import in Panel Builder manually. But other than that, the approach is the same. Now we start Panel Builder, create new project with new panel. Let's say it's going to be this Pro panel. As mentioned, we have our tags automatically created. Let's just make them available throughout the project. Now let's add a couple of interface items. Grab this numeric value, let's make it a little bit bigger, say 16. Then add a label, make it the same size, adjust to the right, and name it counter. Now we attach numeric field to circular counter tag, so in the runtime it'll be updated with actual value. And we repeat the same for the threshold tag with copying and pasting. Change access to read-write so we can write into it in runtime and make it somehow different. Now it's a simulation time. Get back to Automation Builder, enable simulation mode and upload the application. Counter is being incremented as expected. Now Panel Builder. We go to Run, Start Simulator, and currently tags values are being simulated. We can change threshold value and nothing will really happen. But if we untick Use Simulation checkbox, HMI simulator will try to connect to configured PLC. It will still not work, but we're actually halfway through. Here's a trick which will make the HMI simulator connect to the PLC simulator. We head to Protocol section. Here is automatically created Codasys V3 driver with a simple configuration as a dictionary. We click to configuration, and instead of PLC IP address, we put loopback adapter IP 127.0.0.1. In case you don't know what loopback IP is, it's just a fancy way to tell one application to connect to another application on the same computer. Now we start simulator again. Disable driver simulation and hey, look, something is going on. Let me rearrange it a little bit so we have both windows at the same time. If we change threshold in HMI part to 1500, we have the variable value changed in PLC as well. Let's try the other way around. Put 2000 in PLC simulator and check it in HMI. 2000 indeed. Isn't it nice, huh? But there is one caveat. Communication between two simulators will only work with either Codesys V3 ETH protocol or with Codesys V3 handler. But if you use AC500 together with CP600 panel, chances you would use one of those protocols are pretty high. Anyway, keep automating with us and have a lovely day. Thanks for watching. See you guys in the next one.